how to make the method superior? How to correct Jacobi method? Which method better? The answer is Gauss-Seidel will use to correct the Jacobi method. All right? We are going to implement the same matrix. Okay, this is not a proven. Yeah? This is a story how to develop the formula of Jacobi and Gauss-Seidel. So we are using the same matrix, AU equal to F. Matrix A is a full matrices. And then we transform to the linear system, same as Jacobi. All right, I copy paste. I put down for notes Gauss-Seidel. All right, and then what's different? I want to update the value for X2 and X3. All right, for X1 and X2. All right, so for Gauss-Seidel method, all right, what we do, okay, we need to use new iteration. We need to use the new iteration, new calculation, new value, not using Jacobi, all at the previous iteration. So we want to use a new iteration, all right? So now let's we continue. To get X1K plus 1, okay, to get X1K plus 1, we want to use new, okay, new value, new iteration, okay? To get XK plus 1, X1, all right, so you will use X2 and X3 at the previous step as the initial condition, what we call initial condition, all right? So first, all right, for first iteration, for Gauss-Seidel method, okay, use K plus 1 is a K equal to 0 plus 1 X1, 1. Okay, X2 and X3 we cannot do because we need to use the previous iteration, okay, the previous iteration. Okay, X1, X2, 1, okay, you can use, okay, X1 at the, this one is a Jacobi or Gauss-Seidel, okay, this one is a Gauss-Seidel method. So, you can use this one, X2, X1, 1, X3, 1. However, when you want to do X2, okay, you need the point X1 at the iteration 2. Alright, so meaning that whatever you calculate in the similar iteration, you can, okay, use for the, okay, the current iteration, X1, 2. Alright, so this is the difference between Jacobi and Gauss-Seidel. Whatever you get at the previous step for current iteration, you can use for the next step for current iteration. Yeah, X1, 2, 2 is iteration. And then, okay, you have X1, 2 from the previous step and X2, 2 from the previous step. You fit in. Meaning that X3 iteration, okay, at the X3 grid, all the value using the current, okay, the current iteration and the current value. See this one. All the current, okay, the new value. So this is a good of the Jacobi because they're using full matrices at the update value, right? So now if I want to go for the third iteration, okay, this is an important, X3, they're using X1, the current value, X2, also the current. The third iteration, all right, of course lah, X1, we not start the iteration, we use the previous, okay, iteration number 2. However, okay, for X13, okay, you can get from the X13 at the previous step, but current iteration, all right? How about X33? Okay, X3, grid 3, iteration 3, they're using X13 and X23, which is you can get from the previous step for the current iteration. So that's a powerful of Jacobi because they're using the latest iteration. How about the computational cost? Let's withdraw. I told you to draw the computational cost, you need to have I minus 1, I plus 1. I equal to 2, 0, and 3. Okay, I equal to 2, I equal, minus 1 is 1, 1, 2, 3. Okay, we can put. And then you can see this one, computational. They're using the latest, one point at the latest iteration and then previous at the previous iteration. Right, so this is the powerful. Jacobi all depend on the previous time step. Okay, but Gauss-Seidel, there is one point at the letters. For H3, all in the straight line because they're using the current iteration. Alright. So now, okay, how to write the function of Gauss Seidel method? There are two parts. You need to, first you use a old iteration value. The next is a new iteration value. Alright. So there are two parts. Jacobi old. Okay, so there is one part. Alright, from j equal to 1 up to n. But Gauss Seidel from j equal to 1 up to I minus 1. One part. Another one from j equal to I plus 1 up to n. Right. So this one is a k old iteration. This one k plus 1, the new iteration, which is you get from the previous step. Alright. So okay. It's different between table for nonlinear and linear. Alright. Okay, this is my question. Okay, what's different between Jacobi and Gauss Seidel? All right. All are iteration method. All terminate when they fulfill the convergent criterion. All using epsilon. All solving a linear system of equation. But what is different? Want to get feedback from Chu? Jacobi is use the old value for iteration. Gauss Seidel use the lattice value for iteration. Very good. This only one. All right. Jacobi, they're using the old version. Okay. I divide Gauss Seidel into two parts. The first part is a lattice iteration. The second is the previous iteration. All right. So now, how about the table? What is different between Jacobi and Gauss Seidel, the table? Come on. Mathematical thinking. Same. Gauss Seidel and Jacobi, you develop a similar table. Alright, you need to find S1, S2, S3 for iteration K equal to 0, 1, 2, 3. Alright, and then you stop iteration when all the grid, meaning that S1 iteration 2 minus S1 iteration 1 less than epsilon. Iteration 2 for S3 minus iteration 1 S3 should be less than epsilon. So, meaning that you always practice the same formula for Gauss Seidel, be less than epsilon. So, this is important for develop the matrix, develop the table for Gauss Seidel and Jacobi. Terminate the iteration when less than epsilon. Alright? So, the second is what should I want to express here is the way how we terminate the iteration. Okay, where all the grid, we have three grid, all less than epsilon, right? So this is the the differences between Jacobi and Gauss Seidel. Okay, I already post to you some example here. All right, so I go to the example if I can share with you. All right, I want to use your calculator. All right. I want you to answer this question. Very simple question. Just one iteration only. But you know what is the old and what is the new. All right? Please differentiate between Jacobi and Gauss Seidel when I give you the initial value, the initial condition. What is the initial value, initial condition? Okay. Is a x1. All right? x1, x2. X3 is equal to 1. All right, it's equal to 1. All right, so this one is the initial condition. All right, second is you are given a linear system. I given already to you the linear system X1, X2, X3.